To determine the derivative of a given function, we might be thinking about the quotient rule because we do have a quotient, but since we have a constant in the numerator, we could change the form of this function so we could apply the general or extended power rule, which includes the chain rule listed here below. So we can eliminate the denominator if we move this up into the numerator, which would change this exponent to negative 2. So we'd have f of x equals 2 times the quantity 3x squared plus 7 raised to the power of negative 2. So now we have 2 times a composite function, and once we know we have a composite function, we want to let the inner function equal u. So here, u is going to be equal to 3x squared plus 7. Let's go ahead and write that over here. U is equal to 3x to the second plus 7. So now we can rewrite the given function in terms of u. We would have 2u to the power of negative 2. So now to determine f prime of x, we need to determine the derivative of 2u to the negative 2 with respect to u, and then multiply by u prime. So using our extended power rule, we're going to have 2 times negative 2 times u to the negative 2 minus 1 times u prime. So this would be the derivative of the given function, but now we need to rewrite this in terms of x rather than u. So we know u is equal to 3x squared plus 7, but we also need u prime. So u prime would be 6x. So now we'll perform these substitutions into our derivative function. So f prime of x is going to be equal to, here we have negative 4, and then we'll have, instead of u to the negative 3, we'll have 3x squared plus 7 to the negative 3, and instead of u prime, we'll have 6x. And now there's one more step to simplify this. Again, we can think of all of this as being over 1. So if we move this quantity to the denominator, it will change the sign of this exponent. So our derivative function will have negative 4 times 6x in the numerator, so negative 24x. And our denominator will be the quantity 3x squared plus 7 to the positive 3 power, or cubed. So here's the final form of our derivative function. So as you can see, as long as we can identify this as a composite function, let u equal the inner function, rewrite the function in terms of u, it's a fairly straightforward process by applying the extended power rule, which includes the chain rule. Which basically means we found the derivative of 2u to the negative 2 with respect to u, and then multiplied by u prime. And then we had our derivative. And then from there, it was algebra. I hope this was helpful.